going on, guys? Today we have a special for you today. Something that's not even out yet on the market. It's the Mosquito by Furious FPV. Check that little guy out. So this is, full disclosure, I did pay for this. I did not actually receive it for free. I received it at a discount, but I did pay for it. And I was given this to do a early review on the product. So basically, this guy, I've never flown it yet. Still has a little red GST plug on it. I am going to go ahead and pull that off. I have a bunch of E-Flight packs, actually. I'm going to be flying it with this guy right here for testing, so we can get it to focus. There we go. It's a 450 milliamp, 65C 2S battery. And we also have these little guys. They are 300 milliamp, looks like 35C batteries. So these two packs are going to be what I'm using to test this guy on. One thing I will tell you, these 300 milliamp packs are amazing. They'll actually fit. You can see the little holes right here. These little rubber bands that are right down here on the bottom, they actually hold the battery in. So these 300s will fit perfectly. Unfortunately, the 450s that I have, they do not fit. You can see that the pack is actually a little bit wider than the little gap there. And I will tell you that this is, since it is a pre-production model, everything that's red on this quad is actually 3D printed. When it comes to you and the production models, they will be injection mold. I've talked to Steve over at Furious FPV, and he did tell me that the injection mold should be done here shortly, so hopefully I'll have that to review with you guys as well. But I will tell you, I haven't flown this thing yet. This is the first time we're talking about it here, and I think it's pretty amazing. It's pretty well built. It's super tiny. Here is a tiny whoop for comparison, one of my little tiny whoops I have. You can see that these guys are not much bigger than each other. Yes, the blades and the prop guards are, but the actual wheelbase on them is, they're pretty similar. Let's see if we can get a shot there. I mean, they're really close. The biggest thing is the weight, obviously, but I think this thing is going to be a game changer. I think it's going to kill the tiny whoop market. It's going to be so much fun. They do have little tiny, can't really get a good video or a picture of them, but those little guys, those are DYS 10,000 kV. I believe they're 1104s, or 1102s, sorry. But initial thoughts, this thing looks amazing. Furious FPV did a really good job putting everything together. Looks like it's got about a 1.5 mil plate for the body. Everything else is stacked right inside there. See if we can get a close-up on it. You can see the flight controller with the USB cord, or the USB connector on it, and then it's got the receiver right above it. This is the Far Sky version, and then the, let's see better on this side. If you look up in there, you can see the VTX just kind of, let's see if we can get it to focus. There we go. The VTX kind of sticking up in there. It's just kind of set underneath the camera here. Going over specs really quick. This guy is a 70 millimeter quad. They claim a 1 kilometer range via the integrated Far Sky receiver. 7 amp D-Shot compatible ESCs. Haven't done any sort of upgrades or hooked this thing to a computer for the first time yet, so we'll be doing that here shortly. Runs off the 2S packs, which we have right here. Special 45 millimeter props, these little green guys. I only do have one set, unfortunately, so I hope that hope that's not a bad thing. Hopefully I won't need because of the prop guards, but we'll see. It says they come with a LHCP antenna. I talked to Steve over at Furious FPV, and they did install a right hand for me. These are going to be an option after talking to him, so it looks like once you order these, you should have an option between the right or the left hand, which is awesome. I personally have no left hand antennas, so the right hand was kind of a must for me. They claim it's 45 grams without a battery, and let's see here, it's a 25 milliwatt, kind of normal for the tiny whoop, 25 milliwatt 5.8, incompatible with, once again, all of the Far Sky. This guy says Tyrannus, Tyrannus Plus, Horus. I don't know anybody who has a Horus, but XJT modules. I think that's pretty much as far as it goes for the specs. I mean, you guys have probably all seen this. I don't want to waste too much time on it, but kind of want to do a video before I actually flew it for the first time, give you guys a chance to see it. This is what it looks like. Like I said, once again, everything on this guy is 3D printed, so this will be changed on the production, but on the production ones, but this one is pre-production. From what it looks like, these won't be out until February unless you're super lucky and win the raffle on the Furious website. So, once again, normal tiny whoop, Furious tiny whoop. Like I said, a little bit bigger, but I think it's going to be well worth it. And I'm going to be testing it with the 450 milliamp and the 300 milliamp packs, both high discharge, 65C and 35C. Nanotechs, I just have like 30 of these things laying around from an MCPX. So that's what I got. And I will be changing the JST connector, little red guy right there, to the eFlight plugs. Once again, I have so many of them, so why not? But hope you guys enjoy what you see, and should have some good footage here for you shortly. Test them out and see how it goes. So we're going to go ahead and hook up the mosquito for the first time to the computer here. See what the settings they have on it, and what we can do with it, and what firmware it's running. Go ahead and plug it in here. Wait for it to pop up. There we go, USB modem. Let's go ahead and connect. Looks like they're using Betaflight 3.01, which is not the newest one, for the Pico boards. Let's see. Let's go ahead and calibrate the accelerometer while we have it sitting here. I like to do it twice. It's probably unnecessary, but hey, whatever. Don't care. Make sure everything's working the same way. So we're going to tip it forward, tip it backwards, right, left, spin, spin. All right. Let's go ahead and hit up the ports here. So it looks like we get Serial RX on UART3, Far Sky for the telemetry. Looks considerable to the same for the AcroWarp V2. Looks like they're running multi-shot on the ESCs as of now. We'll go ahead and double check those later. Minimum throttle set at 1080. I'm not really going to change a lot of these settings. I'm just kind of going over what they have it set up as right now so you guys can see it as well. Looks like it's running an 8K, 2K. And telemetry is installed or set up as of now. Looks like everything's pretty normal here. Looks like these look pretty... not too close to stock, but they're close. I don't have any receiver bound to it as of right now, so nothing will show up. I do have an arm. I like to do my arm. We'll set it here. Let's put air mode in. I do normally fly 100% acro, however, for the time. For testing this little guy out, we're just going to go ahead and set them all up. I want to run all the tests I possibly can on it and see what's going on. So when I have the mode switch, we're going to be in angle for the first time. Second part, we're going to be in horizon. And then the third position, we're going to be full-blown acro with air mode on. The reason why I have arms set on both sides here, just in case I accidentally hit that switch. Looks like that'll be good. Let's go ahead and save that. Let's see, we're saved. Looks like all the sensors work. I think it looks cool. I just like to test those out and make sure what's going on there. Everything else looks to be set up correct. Double check this one more time. And I'm going to go ahead and bind it up to my Tyrannus. And I'll check back in with you guys here in a little bit. In here, got the Mosquito 70. These are some Hubson three-bladed. They are upgraded. I think they call them upgraded three-blade props for the Hubson 107Ds. And I was told by Steve at Furious FPV that these things are kind of a alternate for the one that I broke, since I'm waiting for him to send me new ones. You did have to enlarge in the holes. They actually don't fit these very well. I also got a pair of these guys, little tiny three-bladed props. There we go. Maybe not. Okay. Anyways, the only problem with these is you can see if you stick them in here, they actually don't fit. They're a little bit too big right there. So what I've done is I've cut some down. They're not the best job, but they do work. And So I'll show you how I did this a little bit later, but you'll see here, I can actually take and put it right in there, and it will fit inside the duct. Just like that. It'll actually clear it just as good as a stock blade as well. Stock blades are a four-bladed tri-blade, or quad blade, and this guy is a little double. If you notice the pictures on a lot of them, they've actually changed to the twin blade. So I'm going to go ahead and test these out. The fog is setting in outside, so it's going to kill my battery life. It's getting pretty cold out there, so going to go ahead and... I flew a little bit this morning, and the first flight I had, this guy flew around, and I did a flip, and I wasn't paying attention how close I was to the ground, and it landed upside down in the snow. So what I'm going to do is we're going to take it apart now. I'm going to go ahead and drone dry it. It is this stuff right here, drone dry. Let's see if we can get it to link up there. Bink. Drone dry. We'll have the link in the comments below. So go ahead and check them out. We're going to test this out and see how well it works. And enjoy the video of taking this apart and drone drying. We're also going to put it back together. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and take apart this guy. I'm going to go ahead and use the drone dry on it. Get that to focus maybe. There we go. Drone dry. Now we're going to go ahead and take this completely apart. This is the prototype body, so you can see everything red is 3D printed. So just got a couple little screws here to take the top off, and off to the races. Here we go. So next on the list is, like I said, these props, they don't fit inside the ducts. You can see it overlays right here. It's actually too big. Oops, it falls through. Whatever. Prop is too big. It will not fit inside the duct no matter what you do. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut these guys down to this size. You can see here, fits perfectly inside the duct. It'll spin everything real close, real high tolerances, real tight tolerances, but it'll fly. We're going to test them out. Haven't tried them yet. So what you need, handy dandy nail clippers. I don't know where these I got these from. They look like hell, but they work. So what I've been doing is taking the tip and basically going right here to the top, or that center post in there. Basically you go right to the center post right in the center there, and then I snap them. So let's make sure we got a bunch of props the right size here, the right pattern, everything. make this fit the prop or the motor shaft here, we're going to have to make that hole just a little bit bigger. So what I have is this Turnigy. It's a multi-tool. It's like 16-in-1 or something. But anyways, I found that these specific ones, I got a Phillips head screwdriver, this guy right here. It's a PH00, and then on this end, there's a flathead, and it's a 1.5. As far as what all those mean, I don't know, but in case you have the same tool, you can tell. So basically what we're doing on that one, which one is it here? This one right here, is we took the Phillips head side first, shove it in there like that, and kind of just wiggle that hole out. You can see it go in there. It makes it pretty straight. So we're going to do this on all these guys here. So we've done a little bit of flying with this thing, as you saw. Sorry the video was so crappy last time. The RF signals around here with the Wi-Fi was just horrendous, and I hadn't changed the channel on this guy just yet. So set on Raceband 6 now. Should be a little bit better. Did want to give you a little bit of update, though. If you're using these props, these green ones that I talked about, they work. The only problem is with the stock tuning, when you're going into like a left-hand turn, you'll see it on the video, it'll actually tend to drop itself a little bit. I didn't really play with it a whole lot. It was pretty cold that day when I was doing the flights. Just kind of want to give you guys a little bit of footage. I do hope you've enjoyed everything you've seen so far. If you have any questions, please let me know. The new frames and the props should arrive here Monday. I'm going to do a video of those. I'm not going to show you a video taken apart. We've already seen that. I don't want to bore you guys to death. But I will definitely show you the difference between the printed frame and the new induction molded frame, as well as how it flies with these props. We'll tune them out a little bit better. And then we'll also go and throw the two blade stock ones on there now and give you a little bit of a difference between the two. And if you have any questions, feel free to let me know in the comments. If you have, if you like the video, let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear from you guys. But I do want to give you a little bit of final thoughts with this. This so far is amazing. I really, really enjoy this. I think this is going to be fun. I'm going to take this out to my local club/league has a mall that we fly out here. It's called the North Bay Mall. So if you're in Alaska and you want to check out some cool tiny whoop, every Sunday from 2 to basically whenever we get bored, it usually lasts to about 6. We're inside the Northway Mall, right across from the old Foot Locker. Have tiny whoop races. If you don't have a tiny whoop, you don't know what the drones are, you've never seen a drone, feel free to stop on by. We have a few down there. You can use them. They're all FPV tiny whoops with special sauce motors. You can fly. It doesn't cost you anything. You can sit down, bring your kids, have some fun, fly around, have a little bit of a race with us. We do time trial races. We also do see how many gates you can get through in 3 minutes. So stop on by, check it out. But like I said, Furious FPV. Good job on this. This thing is going to be amazing. Till next time, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video with your friends. And also check out Far North FPV's YouTube channel, as well as check out all the cool products you can get from Furious FPV.